most remarkable moment ng buhay po natin sapagkat minsan lang ho tayo magtatapos. Minsan lang ho tayo gaganap sa kalooban ng ating Panginoon. So we need to grab this opportunity. So the message is coming from 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 2 and 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 15. So the word of God says, do your best to present yourself approved a worker who does not need to be ashamed and who correctly handles the word of truth. And 2 Timothy chapter 2 verse 2, and the things you have heard me say in the presence of many witnesses, and trust to reliable people who will also be qualified to teach others also. So the Lord will bless the reading of His word. This is the word of Paul, a well-experienced apostle, the word of admonition, encouragement to a young pastor named Timothy. And that is the historical background. So kung titingnan ho natin, napakahalaga na maunawaan natin bakit ho pinili ng Diyos si Timothy. At ganoon na lang ho ang pagtitrain ni Apostle Paul sa kanyang disciple. Let's take a look about the background of 1 and 2 Timothy. Next slide. Si Paul po ay isang aged and experienced apostle. He writes to the young pastor named Timothy, who is facing a heavy burden of responsibility in the church of Ephesus. The task is challenging. Paul's doctrines must be erased. Public worship must be safeguarded, and mature leadership must be developed. So in addition to the conduct of the church, Paul talks pointedly the conduct of the minister. And Timothy must be on his guard lest his youthfulness become liability rather than the asset. To the gospel. He must be careful to avoid false teachers and greedy motives, pursuing instead of righteousness, godliness, faith, love, perseverance, and the gentleness that befits the man of God. In addition to the conduct of the church, so makita po natin, sabi po ng banal na kusulat ng kanyang history, and Paul was in prison during the time. Nung narinig ho ni Paul ang mga nangyayari sa Church of Ephesus, he was encouraged to write an encouragement, a letter to Timothy. And Paul was in prison, the place from which to expect a letter of encouragement. But that is where Paul's second letter to Timothy originates. He begins by assuring Timothy as his continuing love and prayers, and reminds him of his spiritual heritage and responsibilities. So makita po natin, ang sabi ho, only the one who perseveres, whether as a soldier, athlete, a farmer, or a minister of Jesus Christ, will reap the reward. Paul warns Timothy that his teaching will come under attacks as men desert the truth for ear-itching words. But Timothy has Paul's example to guide him and God's word to fortify him as he faces growing opposition and glowing opportunities in the last days. Students, graduating students of CLDC, Church Leadership Development Training Course, and intensive training for emerging leaders, we need to understand the message of God. We need to internalize the tasks are heavy. The responsibility challenges him. Sobrang laki ho at ng sobrang bigat po ng task na assign sa kanya. The responsibility challenges him. The accountability is visible. Kita ho ng kanyang mga mata na ang kanyang accountability, and one is for sure, no quitting, no retreat, no surrender, and the journey begins. So this is the message for each one of us. Journey to God's divine purpose. Palagpakan mo natin ang ating Diyos sa buhay. Hindi ho ito isang pag-aaral lamang, kundi ito ay isang lakbayin. paraho and spiritual director, Bishop Brother Eddie C. Villanueva, and by the power vested in me as a regional pastor of the Jesus is Lord Church Hong Kong, I hereby declare and confirm that you are now graduates. Congratulations.
Inches later.
May I request the graduates to stand up for the Pledge of Commitment to be led by our regional pastor, Pastor Bart Eaton.
A few moments later.
So, ayon mga kasquad, natapos ang aming graduation kanina mga 5 p.m. na. So, medyo matagal-tagal natapos. Thank you, Lord. Natapos na rin namin yung aming idle schooling. Ayon. And glory to God for about 1 year bago kami nakagraduate. Kaya sobrang thank you, Lord. Ayon, dito kami. Nagaantay na pauwi na naman kami mamaya ng aking BFF. Ayan. Mamaya pang 7 ang aming bus. So, dito muna kami. Thank you so much. So, ayun mga kasquad. See you sa next journey ko. In God's will. Hindi ko pa alam, but God's willing. Yun. So, thank you sa inyong pag-support sa aking channel. Thank you so much. We love you, mga kasquad. Bye.